Skibbly-doo.
Skibbly-doo.
Skibbly-bop.
Welcome to the Scatcast. Not that Scatcast. Oh, whoa.
Duh.
No, not that one.
Oh, God.
Every time there's a...
I know some people might think we're shit, but Shaun...
There's a Mega Drive game called Scat, and every time I see it, I'm like, oh, no.
Oh, there is. It's right. Fucking Mike Matei talked about it on that.
Yeah, it's like... I mean, I know you were going for something else, but come on, man. You're being shit now, aren't you? You're being hate shit, literally.
Anyway, welcome back to the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure podcast featuring Jeff as Jeff.
And Shaun as Shaun.
I thought you were going to go with Snake's Revenge.
Michael Douglas. Welcome to RaDIO JOJO episode 3.
The part of Jeff will be played by Baby with a chainsaw for a hand.
Featuring the schools unit.
God, I love that one gif where that black guy's like, he's like, what the fuck? That one's great.
Oh, man.
Because that's my reaction every fucking time those assholes.
Every
time they show up. Hate them. Shoot a rocket, they're like, whatever.
Nobody ever suspects the skulls, man. No one. Alright, guys. First of all, gotta do an apology for last week, because as you may have noticed, all like 50 of you that listened to this, there wasn't one last week because I was on holiday and I was really stressed out and I couldn't get it together. Plus, just between us guys, you know, the news wasn't that great then. But we got a lot of shit to talk about this week. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there wasn't really a whole lot going on.
Yeah, it's gonna be slow. It's a slow season. But we're back. We're better than ever. Next week's going to be awesome as well. Yeah. So, Jeff, have you got any update for us? How's your life? What's your life in JoJo's at the moment?
Life in JoJo's or life in general? Because I just picked up the Sky of 5.
Oh,
feeling pretty
rad.
That and my love story. Anyway, the color update is that part 2 is still being worked on. Person working on that is he just got a new job, so
great.
He's trying to adjust to it before, because he said he was gonna finish. I know him, he's gonna finish before December, more than likely, because he's only got 3 volumes.
Oh, right on.
Yeah, so part 2 is almost done. Part 3, actually, okay, so here, part 3 is funny because I wasn't supposed to come back to work on part 3, and neither was the guy, and the other guy wasn't supposed to help work on it, but two of us jumped on to part 3 because the only guy working on it, I think he's a younger kid in high school, I'm not sure.
Oh,
I don't really talk
shit.
To him too much, but he's done more than anyone else who's ever signed up with us, that's worked with us before. So, he's just about done with Volume 8. He's been going kind of slow on that. He's only got one chapter left. I wish he would just finish it up, you know, because he wants to do Volumes 9 and 14. Actually, Shaun, Volume 14 is probably one of your favorites, because
it
features
it is,
Vanilla Ice. And
yeah.
He wants to... I was going to do it. I told him I will fully do that. You know, it's not a big deal. He's like, no, I want to do it. I'm like... All right, I'll let you know. Go ahead. It's not a big deal because the other guy who's working me, he just finished up. He's about done with volume 11, which featured all Darby the Gambler.
Oh,
and he did something.
Holy
you know
shit!
You know that one? Everyone's favorite part in it when Darby goes call, 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 like he's thinking it. He's like screaming it. Well, he did something really cool with it because Viz. They didn't do a great job with it because that was early Viz and her editing wasn't great.
Yeah,
and the stuff online looks like shit too. So he actually did something really cool, and I think people are gonna like it when they see it if they care enough. You know, they don't have to. And he's gonna handle volume 13 as well, which features all of Terrence, because Terrence deserves a volume.
Man, I'll
never Terrence. Get over that. He gets a whole volume. I don't think anyone else in part 3 got a whole volume except Dio. Well, Dio got 2 volumes.
But it's Dio. So.
Yeah, it's Dio, but Terrence is a minor villain, so I guess he's not really major, you know.
He's interesting.
He's interesting enough, I guess, but a whole volume?
I know.
It's so weird. So my end of it was volumes 10 and 12. I did all those in like
the
span of 2 weeks, within 2 weeks.
Is that Maria and
Alessi? Volume 10 is Mariah. The end of the Mariah fight, it's all of Alessi. Excuse me. And it leads into... that's what the whole volume is. And then volume 12 is Pet Shop versus Iggy, essentially. That's the most important part of it. And I redid... me and the other guy... By the way, this is the same guy I worked on part 4 who did most of it. And we're redoing the last two volumes for Stardust Crusaders because I don't like how it looks. But... important thing to note, this is only for download. I'm not taking the stuff that's on Toto offline because it'd be a little weird to say, I guess, but it's out of respect for the guys who worked on it before.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I don't want to take it down because the people who worked on it before, they don't work on the manga anymore with me, with us at all. So it's how I started, and I feel like it should stay.
It's like a homage to them.
Yeah, I mean...
And your older work as well.
You know what? Leaving it up there also gives me a good reminder not to be shit anymore. Because my old stuff is horrible. Actually, I should show you some pages later, Shaun. I think I've shown you a few.
Yeah. You've been through the MS Paint saga, man.
Oh, yeah. When I...
We've all seen that.
A lot of people don't know that. I started on MS Paint. With the color pages, actually. And it looked... Don't ever use Paint. That was a mistake.
Never.
I did. I'm an idiot. And then with the GIMP. And then I got good and got Photoshop.
And now you're pro. Part now you're
four,
king.
Oh, big thing. Part 4. Part 4 is done. There's only Cheap Trick. That's it.
Wow, really?
Yeah, Cheap Trick's it. And then the volume's over and part 4 is completely done. And funny enough, the guy who worked on part 4, the main guy, he went back and he got the Photoshop documents, which are edible documents for the manga. So he can redo, because he wanted everything to align better with his work that he's done the majority of the time with part 4.
Yeah.
So when he re-uploads, they're not going to, these also are only going to be download only, but it's going to be more in line with his current work. And he reworked the the last two volumes for part 4. He title set everything. He put all the titles down on it, because online they're not set, because the guy who did it, he's stated himself, he's not an artist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dax and Dan is the guy who did it. And he said he's not an artist, so he didn't put the titles down, but the guy who's working on it now, he set all the titles. And he made use of some cool effects on the text and stuff. It just pops more. But it's just, you know, more JoJo stuff. I hate talking about part 5. It's going so slow.
Yeah, it's a bit of a snail's pace.
People keep asking me about it, and the only thing I can I guess I can tell you what Dan told me. A mean Brazilian won't let me work on it.
Very mean.
Dan was the one who told me to just tell people that. A mean Brazilian doesn't care. I really wish he would, go a little bit faster. Because he told me at one point he's behind the translator. So I don't know. I mean, hey, it looks good. He's still putting them out, so, you know. I do like the new translations that have been coming out. I've been keeping up with, obviously, all of his stuff. And, it just reads a lot better. One thing to note about Part 5, Dan, early on, was, if they're going to do this, he wants to keep it, more Italian, how it's, I guess, supposed to be. But, say when Pesci's screaming, you know, what's brother in Japanese? He yells it in the PS2 game, but Dan actually is keeping it more Italian. So he's saying whatever brother is in Italian. Some people might not agree with that. Some people
Kind of hit and miss. That's kind of like the same logic that the anime is going in, you know, with the accents.
Yeah. So, I mean, that was a decision between him, the translator, and another guy he's working with.
It could work, because, there is a lot of, English incorporated in, so it could make sense.
I don't see why not, you know. Part 6. Okay, so I just got back to doing Part 6 because I just finished Part 3. And when I told you I was trying to work on that chapter last night, I fell asleep at the computer. I was totally mean. Because the last couple of days, I've only gotten like 3 hours of sleep each day.
Yeah, and you're finally insane. Kicked, you are we were insane,
talking on,
man.
Yeah. When we were talking on Skype, it finally kicked in. And I was like, all right, fuck it. I'll work on it later. And it's volume 3, and this one's really important to go up because this is new translations for it. Which, wait until you read the Thunder stuff, because it's like he sounds even more pathetic than he did before. Like, he's literally calling himself pathetic almost every other sentence on how sad of a sap he is.
Well, he's not lying.
Well, I mean, that's his whole deal. He makes himself feel bad and he victimizes himself, but it's just. The translations just are way better this time, so you just get a better idea for it. It's fucking hilarious. It's cracking me up. Part 6 is slowly getting back up there. This whole month I'm going to be focusing more on Part 6.
Right
so
on.
So you get the new text and translations out for everybody. And Part 7 hasn't updated in a while. Mainly because we've been focusing on parts 2 and 3, you know, because we'll have by the end of this year we should have parts 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6 all out. It's not bad.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that's a lot of color manga that people could be reading if they want. You know, it's up to you.
If you want.
But bear in mind, especially with part 3, I actually had some new translation work done for it. Because the online stuff and even the Viz stuff, the translation, some of it doesn't make sense. The Viz stuff makes more sense than what's online, straight up. Like,
well, you'd hope so, wouldn't you?
The thing is, people don't some people get really pissy about official translations sometimes, but, and I'm serious with this, you guys gotta understand, the Viz stuff isn't wrong. Like, okay, let me give you an example. Dio's speech, remember when he's like monologuing to himself and talking to Jotaro?
Yeah.
And he's like, your reasoning is like rat shit or rat shit on in the bathroom. Now, on the online stuff, they didn't include all that extra, like, what Dio's saying, right? And if you listen to the anime, you watch it, he's saying, that's what he's saying. And I had it looked over, and that's what he's, you know, he's saying. There's also the matter of, during the chapters of Whole Horse and Boingo, when Whole Horse is shooting his bullets into the pipe, the Viz stuff and the online stuff both have Whole Horse saying, die, Jotaro, which, okay, so I had it looked over again, because I'm like, you know, it doesn't sound too right. So I had a good friend of mine who knows Japanese to look over it, and he's like, no, he's saying, eat this, Jotaro. He's not saying, die, which I think makes more sense with Whole Horse's, like, personality, because he's not really like a guy who kills for the thrill of it. I don't know, it's really hard.
Yeah,
to...
he's not a mercenary, he's just a guy who does, it's his job. So.
I mean, he kills people, yeah, don't get me wrong, he's not a great guy, but the Whole Horse never came off as like the murderous, like ruthless guy. Or like, for instance, on the online stuff for the Alessi fight, and this was a big thing to me, was that the online stuff has his favorite phrase is marked as impressive. That's what he says is his favorite phrase. But the Viz manga has him saying good boy. It doesn't make any sense for him to actually say impressive. Because he's supposed to come off creepy.
Yeah.
You know, it just... There's just some things that don't work too well. Or like, I actually had it redone. You know the part where he like... one of the most famous iconic parts and scenes in part 3 is when he uses the axe on the door and scares Polnareff when he's a baby. Or he's a little 3-year-old or whatever.
The Here's Johnny.
Yeah. I listened to it in the anime and I had it checked out again. He's not saying Rero. He's saying Pero, which is lickety.
Right.
Even fucking creepier, right?
That's why we call him Jeff Lessie.
God, don't even remind me of that shit.
Da 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 da.
Let's not even talk about that ever. Let people guess. So, yes, I've had some translation work redone for part 3, because to be honest, the online stuff isn't great, and it needed it. This is where I would highly recommend, and I know some people might not agree with it. I know one person in regards to this, because he doesn't like name changes, but the Viz stuff is really on point with the translations. Like, another thing I had changed, I actually asked someone who knows French, because in the Viz stuff, he's saying stuff in French, and I couldn't, like, get anyone to help me with the Japanese completely. So what I did is I took the French and translated into English. I have to go through it again, see if it's all right, but, It's just a real pain to do all this translation work that should have been done already.
Yeah, like some professionals should have really sorted this out.
I've been just trying to make sure more on point, you know?
Yeah.
Was there anything else I wanted to mention about it? I can't wait to show everyone Volume 3 of Stone Ocean, though. Like, all of it, because the translations are just so much more phenomenal. And, it just, the key thing about those, the last two chapters, The Visitor Part 9, that has Jolene and Jotaro, where Jotaro loses his stand and his memory, is really actually important to their characters, their relationship between father and daughter, actually. Those translations as I have them now, sitting on my computer waiting to be uploaded, are way better than what's online, and it actually makes more sense on how the relationship works.
And it enhances both characters as well, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah, and actually, Jotaro, you can see he cares. Like, because in the translations now, it's too weird, so it sounds like he doesn't really care that much, but he really does, which is funny. Even early on, he cared enough about his daughter. I mean, it doesn't seem like it, but it does. Just wait until you read it.
You guys will see it eventually.
Especially the White Snake shit. Like, that really didn't make any sense. But just talking about melting people and their hearts. it's wacky. I love it. Oh, one other thing.
Oh.
This is not that important, but at the same time it kind of is. Some of the translations involve titles. They're changed. For example, the one title of the chapter is A Prisoner's Melody, right? No. The actual title is called A Prisoner of Love, when Jolene's getting Jotaro to the sub. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's the name of the title. It's actually A Prisoner of Love. The other title, actually, it's not Hermes Kiss. It's Hermes Sticker.
Oh. That sounds a bit lame, to be honest.
You know what? It does, but makes more sense.
Yeah, it probably makes more sense.
But it makes more sense, but it doesn't sound as cool. It's kind of like, alright, this is kind of like the thing, when I read through the JoJoyums for part one, the last couple of for the last couple of chapters, you know, on the boat, it's actually Jonathan and Dio, Fire and Ice, parts 1-6. It's not, the last chapter's not called Into the Oblivion.
Oh.
Which is weird, because if you go back and watch the anime, that's the title of the last episode.
We're just throwing all the continuity out the window now.
Dude, I don't even know, like,
what even is the real chat? Like, what even is the real
chat? What Araki originally had, those are the titles. Like, it's really weird, because the Chinese titles are the ones that Ignition 1 went off of. But if you watch the anime, it'll say Dio the Invader, you know, that's the first episode of the anime. Then the second episode's like Letter from a Friend, I think, or Letter from the Past, or no, that's like the third episode. Letter from the Past, which is in the online, Ignition 1 did, but it's actually Dio the Invader parts 1-4.
Yeah, I'm not too fussed on the whole chapter renaming thing. Mainly because you guys got to remember is that it was actually like a weekly series. So you got to remember, like, each of these chapters were coming out weekly. So for him to just, like, stick part 1, part 2, part 3, it's kind of justified rather than these really elaborate descriptive titles.
Some of them were. But, like, a lot of it was because they're connected. So, like, the parts would go. It's like, I don't know. It's really ridiculous when you go through these translations. Oh, excuse me. Oh, and for part 6, I actually have I don't know if I told you, I got a professional translator. Like, this dude does paid work. So, like, he knows his shit, you know, when it comes to this. And his translations are really fun to read, too. I really like them. That's about it. All I got for color update. Wow.
That's quite a big update, to be honest. You guys are working really hard.
Yeah, yeah, we're trying our best, trying to get everything done.
Okay, I'll throw something on the end of this then. As you remember, the last episode we had kind of a pickup section, and so I've actually got some pickups this week because last week for me was a bit dry. I didn't have much.
I feel like a shithead because I don't have any.
Oh no, your time will come, man. Your time will come. You'll be like, dude, I brought 6 Velas again.
I bought the limited edition Velar. Why?
Well, I just asked what I just wanted to, you know. So, I finished my SAS collection for Star Wars Crusaders, which was, I'm really happy for. The ones I actually had left to go were really lame. They were like, it's just like Silver Chariot and Magician's Red.
Yeah.
So I got them and I was like, wow, they're not that interesting, per se. But I'm still hyped to finish it. I put them all together with all the
Well, yeah, because you really love Part 3, right?
I do. That's the one I really wanted to finish, rather than anything.
It's probably the easiest one to finish.
Yeah, because before I even started, all the sets were out already, so I was like, I can just pick them up.
I can't imagine any of those stands or any of those characters being really hard to get.
No, the only hard one to get really was, like, this Silver Chariot was quite hard to get because they've re-released it so many times. It's easier to get the second one or the Vento one, but I wanted the original one because it comes with the Anubis swords.
Oh, nice.
So I was like, that's pretty cool. And I'm trying not to break it, even though I nearly broke one of his hands. It's so finicky because Silver Chariot's like the first one to come out. Its hands are really, really old. You can feel it, like, it's going to snap any second.
Just like the Color Project. Those guys have come a long way.
They're just all dust now. And Magician's Red, there's nothing much to Magician's Red. He's just a big fire chicken. So,
like, I love that. I always love that joke.
There's not much to him, but when you put him next to Abdor, he's like, oh, okay, yeah. You feel the power. So all I got to do now, because Iggy comes with Joseph, but he doesn't actually have a stand.
Oh yeah, his stand is like separate.
Yeah, it's a statue legend, so I have to get one of them.
Why?
Just because, well, Iggy's just bare. I've just got him in the air doing something. Like.
Actually, you know what? I think I know why. I would take a stab in the dark to why the fool's a statue legend. Simply because it doesn't seem like it has many points of articulation.
Yeah, it's not very poseable.
I guess.
He just kind of stands there.
I'm just making up shit, don't believe me.
It sounds realistic.
It sounds reasonable than anything else you'd hear.
But I'm looking forward to getting that. And yeah, I might get some Statue Legends next, maybe, for Part 3. But they do get pretty expensive. Like, mainly the Death... It's in the Death 13 one.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, mainly that. Really expensive. Oingo Boingo's not that bad.
But really? Yeah, I thought Oingo Boingo would be expensive. It seemed kind of rare.
I think it's quite cheap now. I don't know. I think I saw it in the group and it was like relatively cheap, but I don't know. Maybe. I also picked up some Blu-rays. I think I mentioned before. I'm actually picking the Blu-rays up.
Yeah, you've been posting it.
I got Volumes 5 and Volume 7. Which covers, like, I think Volume 5 is the Santana fight. And it comes with a really weird mouse mat that's way too small for any mouse. The Japanese are really weird. They've either got to be really small or they've got to have huge breasts on. I don't understand. Out of the two options, I'm happy with this one. And Volume 7 covers Wham versus Caesar, which the one that makes everyone a bit leaky in the eyes.
Which is funny when you compare it to the manga where it was like, eh.
Yeah, ugly man gets crushed.
Ugly twink gets crushed by Aztec warrior stripper.
Don't you just hate when that happens?
Yeah, I just hate when a ceiling falls on me.
And that came with the wedding rings.
Oh, really?
They actually look pretty nice.
Wait, like, are you serious? That's hilarious.
I'm not gonna keep them in the box. I'm not gonna, like, try and.
You should
insert it into my throat.
Your throat and an artery on your heart.
And I'd then call your parents and be like, oh no, I've done it again. How could you even get them removed? Probably not. I think you're screwed, to be honest. Only magic will get that off. Just pure magic.
Well, modern science can't remove it, so.
Nah, laser right to the chest. Oh no, we killed him.
Oh no.
You got some good hits in though.
Yeah.
I guess. But yeah, those are my pickups. Not like 20 Velas like you, but.
Oh.
And by the way, I got all those from Mandarake. You should totally buy from them if you haven't already.
What makes them so great?
Pretty cheap. Real though cheap. That's the best thing.
Like they'll just give me stuff for free?
Yeah, just say, give me stuff, and then they'll be like, no. Get out of here.
Oh.
Then you'd be like, well, you know, please. And they'd be like, oh, all right then. Have an Iggy keychain and get hyped like Jolene did.
Oh, yeah. And Jotaro was wearing an Iggy and the Fool, like, pins on his hat.
How? Why would he... It's a constant reminder of how he got brutally murdered by Ice Ice Baby Vanilla Ice.
You never even met Vanilla Ice, too.
What if he had a picture of him under his desk?
Well...
He had a picture of, like... Because they had, like, a staff photo. So maybe, like, they had a picture of Vanilla Ice, Kenny G, and Terrence. And then Deer's in the front, like, really proud.
Weren't they all just, like, butlers?
I think Terrence was a butler.
Yeah,
Kenny
but what,
G.
What was Kenny G?
Kenny G was, like, the illusionist. Like... When Kenny G, if you notice, when Kenny G gets beaten, the whole like illusion of the mansion just kind of goes away and it becomes a normal place.
So does Kenny G do that all the time?
Yeah,
I think that's, 9 to 5.
That's his main thing, really. Nah, like 9 to 9.
Don't know. In the picture would have to be Enya, Dio, Vanilla Ice, Kenny G, Terrence, and Nugasaka,
and Kaz, Ocelot,
Big Boss. All those children, liquid.
Just everyone.
Neptune.
Happy days.
From Neptunia.
Bill Cosby.
Bill Nye, the science guy.
Everyone.
Nukem.
Dude, no, he's not allowed in. He's too crude.
James Rolfe.
Or every time.
The Pip Boy.
Okay, you got any more?
Frankie from One Piece, I don't know.
Stop! Why does every episode have to end like this?
Kirito's in there. I guess.
Jeff, do you want to talk about the news?
Yes, let's talk about the news as presented
the news.
To us by you, the people.
Thank you, guys. You guys are amazing.
Yeah.
If you ever have any news, by the way, you should totally let us know.
Yeah, tell me or I'll kill you.
Yeah. Is your life that important that you won't give us the news? Come on, guys. Just. But yeah, we got a ton of news, although it's mostly stuff from last week and updates.
Yeah.
We're in the slow season. But never mind that. Eyes of Heaven.
Holy shit.
Eyes of Heaven.
It's a video game.
Huge update. Huge. Have you seen the trailer? You've seen the trailer.
The trailer's pretty sweet.
The trailer is great.
Just
it's
character
got,
drop after character drop.
It's got a story.
Which ASB...
Eyes of Heaven never had... No, not Eyes of Heaven, sorry. All-Star Battle never had a story.
It did. It just had a really shitty...
It had text fight, gappy...
Why was the US trailer better than the story mode?
That's... Why, yeah.
The trailer they released for the US version, like, was better than the story mode they put out. There was just more going on.
That's just really embarrassing.
Their balls run stream, so.
But they've learned.
Yeah,
they
not that
learned, because
stream.
This looks like it's got a really interesting story.
Well, that and Araki's overseeing it. himself.
He's overseeing it. Not only is he overseeing it, he's adding an original character.
Yeah, which everyone knows the can of Dr. Pepper.
It's going to be Sonic.
No, but seriously, it's going to be Heaven Dio. Everyone
already
guessed it. It wasn't hard to guess. Because if you look at the picture, they didn't put a shadow over the whole thing like they should have. So you see two big-ass Ds on his goddamn pants.
We're talking about the letters here, man. We're talking about the letters.
And he's wearing Dio. He's wearing his shoes. His weird-ass pointy...
Aladdin shoes. But yeah, it does look like Dio, and it probably is. But that's still cool, though, man.
Yeah, that is cool. Some people are like, eh.
But remember, this is not Dio. This is like a made. It's like a made in heaven Dio. It's meant to be final Dio. I've nearly won Dio, but is he gonna win? That's up to you guys. They should have me do the advert. That'd be cool.
We should do it. We should be like, we're blind.
We're blind. We love it. Best video game ever. I can't see it, but it's great. It sounds amazing. And it really does. Did we talk about it last time? If we didn't, Part 4 Jotaro is going to be in the game. I think we might have mentioned that already.
Yeah, yeah.
But he's in. He's got new moves and everything.
I hope. There's nothing that's been shown on.
Was there not? I think there were some screenshots.
I think. I don't think there was anything in his move showed off, just him in the game.
Ah, just him. Come on, guys. I hope, hopefully, he has some new moves. Or just get rid of some moves.
Yeah.
Though it is, like, it's an arena game, so it's not really going to have, like, everyone's not going to have, like, 20 moves and 20 references. It's going to be really small stuff, but, you know.
I mean, I hope he has a lot of different, like, something different to offer. I mean, the world, for instance, is... the world. Star Platinum, the world.
Star Platinum, the world.
That's the big world. That's the big world one.
It'll have some, like, different quotes and stuff.
Well, if you look at the SAS figure, like, it looks different. His bigger eyes, for one.
He looks like a man who's seen some shit.
Looks like a Pop-Tart.
Yeah.
He's got the Pop-Tart flavors going.
One thing I did like about the trailer was it shown a lot of the unique tag teams in there.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
Which is really good. Like, we saw, like, Dio and Giorno. We saw Dio and Dio. And Dio was like, I ain't having none of this other Dio. Fucking blast him in the back.
There's that picture that's been going around. It's don't trust anyone, not even yourself. And it's part one Dio shooting his laser eyes at part three Dio. By the way, I hope part three, part one and part three Dio talk about that. Part one Dio is like, what happened to the laser eyes?
Yeah, part why do you do that?
Part three Dio is like, these laser eyes, like, stop time.
And he's like, why not both? And he's like, shit.
You know, I probably should have thought of that. By the way, speaking of the story mode, from what I hear, the story is going to take place at the end of part three when Jotaro kills Dio and they're in the airport and then Speedwagon's there.
Like, what?
Yeah, I don't know. So...
And it's probably going to be Speedwagon, like, as he was in part one. Like, that age. Like, how...
Time travels have... Like, this game is going to get really ridiculous.
It's going to get nuts. It's going to get bizarre, you might say.
Just a little.
Oh.
The ending to part 8's in this game.
Oh, my God. That would be such a seller. I don't even know.
That'd be ridiculous.
People would buy it. No, they don't even care about it. They'd just be like, okay, I want to see this. And then it's like, it reveals, like, Speedwagon was there, and...
Like, it was all a dream.
Oh, yeah, and by the way, it's on some Pet Shop and Vanilla Ice footage, which I know I'm going to be hyped about.
Oh, yeah, it did. There wasn't that much, but, you know.
That's my team right there.
But team, it showed off...
Team OP and Team Bulge.
It showed off the Stone Ocean cast, which was great. They showed a little bit off of Weather... report.
They did.
Which is nice. I'm
really excited for him to be in it.
Also, the stage gimmicks of Part 6 are really cool. They got Foo Fighters fucking... Got Goo Goo Dolls and Limp Bizkit, which are both really unique moves. Well, not so much Goo Goo Dolls, but Limp Bizkit is very unique. There's a picture on the one update. It showed a tiny version of Poochie, and someone's like, "Tiny gay priest has arrived." I thought it was fun. Imagine like him that small, and he has made in heaven. It's tiny. Wow,
they're really pushing Poochie, like in the, all the promotional art.
Yeah, what's up with that? He's
really
everyone.
Pushing it.
And his SAS just came out. It's good timing.
I'm glad they're showing the cover already, because like if I didn't, I'll just assume it would just be Poochie's face on the cover.
No, it's just Poochie's heavily involved in this somehow. Don't know how.
See that segue as well. That's a very nice segue. We can go into the SAS of Poochie. Which, by the way, that looks really great. Though it may be due to the fact he's wearing a dress, so it covers like most of his legs, so you can't really see the ball joints.
You know what's... Oh man, yeah, and that hat.
That hat is... That might even rival Joseph's hat in his SAS.
I don't know. What about that sword Jonathan gets? Luck and Pluck is pretty cool.
You can't wear it on your head, though. Well, you can. Dio wore it on his head for a little bit of time, then he pulled it off.
Yeah. I mean, it could work.
But that is a sweet looking hat.
But yeah, what's up with all the Poochie stuff lately?
It's the year of Poochie, you know, like the year of you, Luigi.
The gay priest has arrived.
He's come. His time has come. 2016 is Poochie year.
The whole year.
The whole year. The holy year.
What else?
It's
Eyes
coming.
Of Heaven.
Apart from the trailer, the original character, we still haven't saw any Steel Ball Run stuff.
Yeah, at all.
Like, we got Diego, obviously, a really early demo reveal.
They just
gave it us. Like, there was that time where they just gave us that. They gave us Stroheim and Speedwagon, and they were like, "Shut up, stop asking for these guys. They're in."
And then here's another thing on the cover. Johnny's on the cover. They have not shown him off yet, but you know, Johnny, Gyro, and Funny Valentine are like confirmed.
Oh yeah, they've got to be.
They're reusing ASB shit, so they got to be confirmed.
It would make sense, yeah.
For Stone Ocean, all they need is Anasui and Foo Fighters, and that's it. You're good.
And you've already got Anasui.
Yeah, Anasui
was
ASB.
Just use that sprite.
So I don't see
not sprite,
not.
Use that model.
But part 7, they have one character. Watch, part 7
go.
Winds up having 10 characters.
I wouldn't even be mad.
Poco Loco is playable.
You just pick him and you win straight away.
Oh, wait.
You were lucky.
Bruno has not been shown off.
Yeah.
Neither is
really interesting.
Man, I got someone.
Diavolo.
Yeah, I keep saying his name wrong. But he hasn't been shown off either. You know they're going to be in the game, but why are they holding back?
Oh, yeah, they've
got
to be in the game.
They're holding back. It's weird. What
just waiting for a trailer, I guess.
What if there's more Part 5 characters? And, like, they're just waiting to show them off.
There should be. There should be some Part 5 villains, like, at least.
There should be more than Stage Hazards.
Yeah. That's a bit disappointing, but... What are you going to do?
Cry about it.
Just See, I'm alright. I like the part that gets about a billion characters, so...
It's my party, and I'll cry if I want to.
Nah, man. You're banned.
Is that a stand yet?
Which one?
It's my party and I'll cry if I want to.
Nah. That's even obscure for a Raki.
This should be... Hey, the Annex Brothers.
The who?
The Annex Brothers or whatever.
Oh, the Apex Twin.
Yeah, there you go. The Apex.
That Apex Twin. That was really... I was so hyped for that.
Didn't expect it.
When's he gonna have a stand called Sandstorm? That would be.
Where's Wake Me Up Inside Stan?
Oh, that's the day's code word. For the Skeleton War.
Everyone's been saying that lately.
It's taken off. If you haven't noticed by now, dude, it's October. The month of.
Skeletons.
Skeletons, spooky times. And not Eyes of Heaven, because that comes out in November.
In December.
Is it November?
December.
Or December. What's the date on
14th,
that?
14th, I think.
14th.
I could be wrong. Don't quote me on that.
Oh, I don't know.
By the way, shout out to the Skeleton Wheels in Dark Souls. Fuck you guys. Shatters.
let me just look now. I can't see when it's out.
It's either the 14th.
It's out the 17th. 17th.
Okay.
No. Pretty close.
I already have it on pre-order.
Damn right. PS4?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
The fuck would I get it from PS3 for?
Hey, there's some guys haven't just unlucky, man. They haven't
get
got
good.
It yet. Get, oh, man. No respect. Anyone who gets it on PS3, you're right with me. Just as long as you buy it. Please buy it.
Yes.
Don't. If, like, I know it's like a... Actually, no, it's not even guaranteed. Like, you, like, please buy this game. Don't wait for the American version, because, like,
if you can buy it, like,
if you don't even buy this version, there's no way it's going to make an American version.
I think ASB came here because people imported it.
Yeah, you, they like, saw you guys kept that game afloat. That game was in bargain bins in Japan.
Yeah, people kicked that shit to the curb.
So, like, the fact that we got it as well probably really helped their sales. So don't get lazy and wait for it to come. Just pick it up now. Pick it up then. It's gonna be like a year's time. Come on, guys.
I'll buy it twice. I'll buy it 8 times.
Do it. You buy like 3 times anyway.
Yeah.
You're an idiot. You know what else is an idiot?
Ooh.
Screw Attack. Yeah, if you don't know who Screw Attack is, Screw Attack, our website. Actually, they're alright. They're not that bad.
They haven't gotten as bad as some people make them out to be. Like, they're not as good as they used to be, but...
Yeah, well, they used to have some, like, strong content. Didn't they have, like, AVGN?
Yeah, that
like
was
everyone.
Back when he had a contract with them.
So. Everyone knows him. But now that their main focus and their biggest attraction is a thing called Death Battle.
Yeah.
Which isn't a very original concept, to be honest. It's been done before.
No, but this one involves characters people want to see in a fight, and it ends
yeah.
up being retarded, but...
It's not just superheroes, it's like they put anime guys and video game guys in there, which is really cool.
They straight up have villains fight each other. They had Robotnik and Dr. Wily fight.
Yeah, it's like when... Like, where else would you see that, honestly?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the fights are cool, they make a sort of sense, but... I don't know, that Dio and that Toho character.
Well, that's different. We've got to distinguish the difference here. So there's one called Death Battle where they, like, think of research and they put them together and they see who would win out of a fight between them based on their skills and stuff. Then they've got another thing, like a sister project called 1 Minute Melee, which is, like, no research, just a bunch of sprites fighting each other. It's like Mugen. They just made Mugen and they made it look a bit better and gave it some nice camera angles. And, yeah, they had... I think it was a few months ago, maybe even a year ago. It was quite long, quite a while ago. They had Dio fight, Dio from Heritage, his sprite. They had a fight some Toho girl.
She stops time and throws knives. I believe she is actually a like Toho references a lot of things. I think she is a legit Dio reference.
Okay, so it makes sense for them to have him fight.
Because I've also seen her paired up with Dio in a lot of numerous fan arts.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
Just, I think she even has the, you know, how Dio says time to stop.
She even does that.
I'm pretty sure, don't quote me on that, but I'm fairly certain she's based off of Dio, personality-wise or whatever.
I mean, so spoilers.
I guess.
Spoilers, they fight, and Dio dies. He gets fucking bodied.
Yeah, he gets, like, fuck you, Dio.
And obviously this pissed off a lot of people because like they kind of thought it was like Death Battle, so they were like, no, this girl would never win. And it's like, dude, they just pulled the winner out of their ass, basically. That's what this thing is.
Yeah.
Just to make it look flashy. So that happened and it was like, okay, back to normal life. But now, as of like 2 days ago, they brought us back.
We've this one was interesting.
This one was really cool. They got Jotaro. Again from Heritage versus Kenshiro, who is like they're like brothers in a way. Like everyone who's a fan of JoJo's kind of stems from Fist of the North Star. I would
some way or another, you know
yeah.
what Fist of the North Star is. Everyone knows Kenshiro and his like famous line. You know his famous line: "You're already dead."
They're like the two of the big three in a way. Like you know, Jotaro, Kenshiro. and Guts. I like the big. They always connect to each other like a triangle.
But I always, because I read through Otsukujuku, so I think Momotaro, but I guess.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's a bit obscure, though.
That's a little more obscure for most people, but I think of him, too, up there now. Yeah.
I'd compare him a lot closer to them than Guts.
Yeah.
Especially looks-wise. Like,
but
looks-wise.
Just really cool characters overall.
Yeah.
You know.
But we've got to make him fight.
So Otaro fought someone who was like, I use my motorcycle to fight you, and he punched the guy and won.
Has he got a sprite at all?
No, not Momo. No, actually, yeah, they do. I'm pretty sure it's that PS2 fighting game for Otsukujuku.
Oh, wow. So there might be one. Maybe one day there might be...
That would be cool. Momotaro's a tough dude, so...
He'd probably lose, though.
He shot... Momotaro shot a tiger, a spirit tiger at someone. It's fucking great. I love it. But the video was really... It was mostly Star Platinum versus Kenshiro.
Yeah, it's not one-sided, but it's like Star Platinum gets a majority of the hits in. He just beats the shit out of Kenshiro.
Because let's be realistic, Jotaro is just a human.
Yeah, like, there is moments where he actually punches Kenshiro and it hurts him, and it's like, that shouldn't really happen.
Because this is Fist of the North Star. Kenshiro slowly walks up to you and then blows
Kenshiro
you up.
Kenshiro is God.
Yeah, essentially.
He is the savior of the world, and when he wins, it's basically like, wow.
The best way to explain Kenshiro to someone who doesn't know manga... is that he's written in a way like Superman's written. He doesn't lose.
He doesn't lose. He's lost.
Like, he's unstoppable.
He's lost two fights, and he later goes on to kill the guy.
Like, so. Look at Superman. You thought Doomsday killed him. No.
Yeah,
his heart rate just
back.
Stopped. Like, his heart rate went one beat. Like, Kari. Like, he wasn't dead. Like, it's just both of those characters. Because I don't really get when people compare Goku and Superman. You should be like Kenshiro and Superman, you know?
Yeah,
but,
a lot closer.
Even then, that's a stupid thing anyway, but it's just Kenshiro's written in such a way that nothing can actually ever beat him. I love the setup for the fight.
Oh, yeah, they just walk in, they actually walk into the same place that the Dio fight ended. And he's still there. Like, dead.
What I love is Kenshiro goes to look at Dio, and Dio pops up right behind him and tries to kill Kenshiro. And then Kenshiro just obliterates Dio.
He's having
but
none of that
as
shit.
As that happens, did you notice they put Dio is dead on there, I believe?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In Japanese.
That was really cool.
That was a cool touch. I didn't expect from them to do it.
They've obviously, like, at least know the content a little bit.
For anyone who doesn't know, if you don't know or remember the series, you know, that too well, it's when Araki would write the character's name, what would happen to them, like their status or whatever. Like, I like for Alessi that he wrote, Alessi, here's his stand, it represents this in Egyptian god mythology, and then single, 38, was blown far away. Like, why did you mention he's single?
Why you gotta blow him up like that, man? Why you gotta make him look like shit?
Like,
because it's Alessi. Yeah.
Like, why the fuck? Why is he single? I don't care.
Like... Oh, you can tell you why he's single. You know?
Oh, well, obviously, I'm just saying, why was it?
So, I like you, Alessi, but this really creepy child habit you have of bullying people.
Yeah, this whole.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit weird.
Gonna have to, give you that bad Tinder score.
Although, because of that, we got one of the better parts out of part 3 when Polmarf hides in the volleyball.
That's true.
One other thing before we go on. Someone mentioned this about the Alessi fight. You know how Polmarf had a mirror in the fish tank? Alessi should have seen his reflection.
Oh, yeah.
He should have. He didn't.
No logic.
Well, it's already silly enough. A 3-year-old's hiding in a volleyball.
To be fair, Polnareff and mirrors, you know, he's already had enough problems with mirrors, man. Just let it go.
Bathrooms, mirrors, and getting thrown off a cliff.
Just let him have that one.
God, part 5, I feel bad for Polnareff. He got rocked.
His whole life is just shit, but... Oh, wow. At least he's not dead.
I guess. that's what you want to call it.
I tell you who is dead, though. Actually, no, did he die in the end? Kenshiro, he didn't die.
No, it was just...
He just got knocked out.
Yeah, he knocked out, and Jotaro was like, blood came out of him.
It was I thought he was going to blow up.
Like, Kenshiro I thought blows Kenshiro up.
Hit his pressure, because he hit his pressure points.
Yeah, no, surely... he said that too. He's like, how can this be...
And I think the answer for that is because he's from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, and he, as long as it's his part, he's invincible.
Essentially.
I don't know. He did spend a lot of time fighting Star Platinum, so I imagine.
Maybe he was hitting Star Platinum.
Yeah. He did use Musou Tensei in the fight, but I don't think they used it as Musou Tensei. I think they just used it as like a dodge.
Oh.
It's a pretty cool dodge animation. So, like, they used it, but they didn't use it officially. But then again, it's no research. It's just
straight
a
up.
Fest.
It's as yeah. if the CPUs were fighting each other.
Yeah.
There's no real logic behind it. So I saw people in the Facebook group were getting a little uppity about it.
That was like, a bit of rage, yeah.
It's but, like, guys, they said they didn't put any time into this.
It's just be happy that your boy won, you know?
Yeah, right, he beat Kenshiro. That's fucking, like ridiculous.
I wish I could say that. Holy shit.
That you beat Kenshiro in a fight?
Yeah. Like, yeah, not many people say that, man. A lot of people that do say that get blown up a few seconds later, so...
Remember what Hart thought? He thought he was going to win, and then he didn't.
Then Kenshiro ate him for, like, an entire week. He provided all that nourishment for the whole journey.
Fucking Hart.
Hart's the best.
Hart sucks.
Oh yeah, and the Kenshiro sprite was from the PS2 game. Fighting game, yeah.
Man, I'm not gonna lie. You put that Arc System Works sprite next to the fucking Heritage of the Future sprite, and it's like, wow, that fucking Arc System Works sprite looks a lot better.
Yeah, looks amazing.
I was like, oh god, this... I love the Capcom sprites, but Jesus, this is... not great in comparison.
Wasn't it a few years after though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was not, and it was on the PS2. But yeah. I
don't know. Well, I think it was on the... It was nearly a Dreamcast game, because it was on the Sega... Was it on the Sega Naomi? Which is basically a Dreamcast.
I think so. No, it was on the Dreamcast, the game, Heritage.
No, I mean the Fist of North Star game.
Oh.
It was on arcade, and I think it was
I don't think it was on Dreamcast, though.
No, it was on... I think it was on the Sega Naomi.
Yeah, at arcades, but like...
Yeah, but that was part... The Dreamcast was made out of them, basically, parts of that.
Maybe you so could... It, I mean, I don't see why you couldn't do it, but...
It probably could have been on it.
By then, the Dreamcast was, like, done, so...
Yeah, it was dead by then.
Unfortunately.
R.I.P. Tell you what, it's also R.I.P. The what? News. We're done.
Oh, we are?
We're done, man. So...
News, next, we're going status, to, we're going retired.
To... Single. So guys, we're going to do the topic next, but first, a word from our glorious sponsor.
Yes.
Hey Jeff.
Hey Sean.
Do you like JoJo's Bizarre Adventure?
Man, I love it.
Have you heard of the manga? Have you seen that?
What? I only own Steel Ball Run, JoJo Leone, Stone Ocean, and Stardust Crusaders. Yes. No, I haven't. Tell me more.
But I bet you got it in black and white.
Ah, yeah.
Don't you just hate the fact that it's not in color?
You know, I was looking at this, and I'm on this part, and it just doesn't look as good. It could be in color.
If only there was some way we could access some color scans with English text.
Yeah, if only.
If only.
Oh, wait. Hey.
What?
I help with that. The JoJo's Bizarre Color Team Adventure. Sounds like
what?
The most racist shit ever, but hey.
That sounds like something you just made up.
A Brazilian came up with the name, so you know it's gotta be racist.
What? JoJo's Colored Adventure Team Color?
Yeah, they've got a blog that never updates, and a Facebook that updates more than anything.
But does it update with relevant content?
Yes, constantly.
Wow.
Except when Dan is like, I'm gonna upload a chapter tonight, but we're not.
Oh, Dan. What's the name of that link, man? You gotta link us. What is it?
It's the JoJo's Color Adventure Facebook.
Ah, nice. What was the name of that blog?
Oh, JoJo's Color Team Blog. It's on Blogspot.
Oh, it's on Blogspot, so it's definitely not active.
Yeah, it's dead. I was the only one updating it for, like, months. Because I was working on Part 6 so much.
Wait, who are you? I thought you were my friend Jeff, who doesn't know about Color Team.
Oh, right. I'm blind.
That just begs more questions.
But I worked on
Part... Why are you even into manga?
I don't... How did I... Where am I?
Yeah. JoJo's Code Adventure. Go check them out.
They're pretty rad.
They're amazing.
I mean, if you're into that sort of thing.
We're really bad at
this. I guess.
We're really bad at this.
And welcome back.
Yay.
From our wonderful message. So
God bless those people.
Yeah. So, the topic, what we want to talk about, are some of the customer reviews for the anime season 1 that just came out in DVD not too long ago, both European and American, because it's very interesting. Also, bear in mind, the European version just came out not too long ago, so there's more reviews for the US version than there is the European one. We're going to go through the European one, because I love the first two reviews when you click on it.
They're pretty funny.
One's like a bizarre adventure indeed, and this guy gave a 5-star review. And the one right next to him is like an absolute disgrace to JoJo fans. 1-star. It's ridiculous the how polarizing all these are. Like, next to each other. This guy's really, really happy about the voice acting.
He's really... He's really pretty overall,
I didn't read over this one, actually. This guy's just... enamored with this. He's just so happy.
This guy sounds like a bot.
Overall, 10 out of 10, an absolute bargain. Actually, at 14 euros.
14 pounds is really good. That's like, was it like $21? Which, that's
ours
pretty
is
good.
Like, ours, if you go to the stores, like I said, is like 30 bucks, so it's not so bad.
It's really worrying how cheap this set is, to be honest, but...
But then you got the next one. And this guy has, if you click on the read more, it's just this long-winded.
I'm going to do that. Let's have a look. Oh, yeah, this guy is not happy.
Yo, he's just ripping into it. He's like, fuck this. But most of these reviews always come down to the menus. They really don't like them.
They're not happy with the menu.
To be fair, like if you look at the Japanese menus and what we got. Oh, man, the Japanese menus are stylish as hell.
Should I go through some of it? Mr. Brandon Lee says, oh dear lord.
Oh dear, yeah, the menu
the
screen.
Menu screen looks like it's done on Microsoft PowerPoint. With cheesy, completely unrelated music playing in the background. So we check the language options, and two, they give you English and Japanese. However, the only subtitle available is English hard of hearing. Which basically means that the actual the Japanese subtitle is not even available. That is really weird, actually. Why would they do that?
I don't know. You're hard of hearing, I guess. So, in short, there's no official subtitle option for the Japanese track. It does come with Italian and French subtitles. Awesome.
Shouts to them. But they do they get the Japanese version, or do they just get the French and
That's
Italian of what's being said?
I have no idea.
In fact, wait, no. It's not in Italian or French, is it?
Okay, so...
It's only in English.
Something this guy brought up, I read this before, actually. It's very interesting because the Blu-ray and DVD set that came out prior for parts 1 and 2 had English subtitles, and they were really good. They were better than what was being put online.
Spot on.
What's really funny is that the subtitles that are on this disc use the change-ups.
Only of what the English dub is saying.
So you're not getting the other translation that was already... made available, so that's really weird.
So in short,
they raised the pitch on the background music and stuff.
Nah, that's not true. Like, that's done in every version.
Oh, okay.
They don't play... The version of the music you get in the actual soundtrack is different to the one they play in the anime because they raise it and drop it for, like, to match the scene. So that's not true. Although apparently it says the openings are actually at a different pitch. So maybe he's right. I don't know.
Also, he's really pissed off right now.
I was going to say. So in short, I am really pissed off right now.
What's the... Oh, there's comments on it.
It's hoping for an official release. So JoJo will be more popular. This is the thing I was worried about. He's like, he wants good presentation. But obviously this is not... a shining example, really, is it? Like,
people have to realize it's JoJo's. The fact that it's even here.
Yeah, it's amazing. Like, the fact that it's even made it this size, amazing. And we're just really unlucky that it's being handled by Warner Brothers.
I'm actually upset because if you look at the old presentation on the OVA stuff, the boxes looked really... Even in English, the boxes.
Yeah, the boxes
really
were
nice.
Good. Had some decent features as well, didn't it?
Yeah,
like,
and it was
behind
all,
the scenes.
You know, it was already full English. You had English and Japanese audio options. It's dual audio already. And besides that, it came out in VHS, DVD, and Laserdisc. And
Laserdisc
covers are amazing. Very beautiful.
You guys didn't even know what that is.
Oh, Laserdisc is the best thing. It's a superior option.
It shouldn't have failed.
A lot of this is just directed towards the menus and just the... I will, like, this one guy on the bottom is like an absolute disgrace. I wouldn't say that. It's like some people are literally really railing against the dub, and the dub's not that bad.
I don't know. I like how both of them are at the top, and I don't agree with any of them. Like, 5 stars is pushing it.
Now, wait, we agree with the one on the bottom. The one that says in all caps, garbage.
Garbage. I was going to read that one next. This guy has been having a really bad day.
Someone kicked his puppy and then took his money. I guess.
Someone shat in his cereal. Because... Oh, okay. Let's
just
read
took
this
a
one.
Piss on his Cheerios.
The production quality on this DVD is dreadful. All the menus look like they're supposed to be displayed on TVs from about 10 years ago. And seem to be designed using incredibly basic software. Helpful hints, if you're going to sell a DVD product, make sure the menus look nice. Especially if it's going to be the first thing your customers are going to see. I kind of agree with that. Now for the options available on the disc. Dub only. The quality for which is similar to the original dub of DBZ. Absolutely dreadful.
This guy's never heard the original dub.
This guy has watched 2 animes in his life.
Yeah, probably.
For a series rated 15, it's almost like they're trying to make it for children. Really wish I hadn't brought it. Suggest none of you do either. Oh, and the video quality is dreadful. Like 240p dreadful.
Wait, what was that? For a series rated 15, it's almost like it's made for children? Like, what? That doesn't even sound like it's connected to this.
I think that's just a personal jab at, like, things like Caesarino.
I love that one.
Every episode, I'm going to try and worm my way into saying.
Does he know what 240p looks like?
Probably. It's probably something on a TV 10 years ago. Shout out to that guy. I mean, by the way, if you guys are actually reviewing and listening to us now, like, in the very slim chance, we're not insulting you. We're just like, I'm finding these hilarious.
I'm laughing at you guys because you're fine.
Just reviews in general.
I just love this last one. Garbage.
Garbage.
Oh my god. That's all the noteworthy ones for the UK, because there really isn't much for...
Okay, let's go into the...
The US ones a little.
The US, which has got a bit more because you've had it a bit longer. Although I'm seeing the same guy. Mr. Brandon Lee. He's actually posted on both of them.
I love Scott J. Simmons. This show is a 5x5. And 5 out of 5 by far. The 1 star is for the product itself. The show comes with English and Japanese audio, which is weird because they weren't saying that in the UK version. The only English subtitles for the Japanese audio, however, are the CC for the dub, so the hard of hearing ones. Menus are even worse. Here's a picture. There's one example. I would recommend the show, but not this product. A huge company like Warner Brothers should know better. It's not off about that, I mean, but something to keep in mind is Warner Brothers does this with a lot of their products. This isn't anything new. I guess people aren't used to that. And you know what's funny? For other cartoons too, they get the same treatment. Like when they go on DVD, they're the lackluster menus. Like I've seen it before. Just like shitty ass menus. Even big movies that are put out. Shitty menus. You know what a nice menu? Kill Bill actually had a really cool menu. I really like that one.
I imagine it's different from movies.
Sometimes
I don't expect to buy The Dark Knight and have it look like it's done MS Paint.
Actually, my mom, she's been watching Fast and the Furious a lot, like the Blu-ray she has. The menus are horrible. It's literally just stock pictures and they have like the same 5-second melody playing.
Is that WB?
I don't know, but it's just really shitty, and it's just, I hate it that it's a bunch of stock photos. You can literally have, like, they have nothing playing in the background. You can have, like, you know, a chase scene or something, you know, fade into another chase scene and just do it like that. Nah. So fucking lame. What's this guy next to him? He's like, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is my favorite anime. Started buying the manga. Oh, wow. That's nice.
He's not really reviewing it, though.
No, he's just like, I started buying the manga. It only makes sense to buy the anime. It's an amazing anime.
Like, I know what this guy's saying, but like...
I love this review.
You've told me nothing.
He told you everything he needed.
He told me to buy the manga. I mean, I guess that's right.
He likes it.
Okay, we need to find some bad ones here.
Bait and Switch. Bait and Switch pre-order for a lower price version cancelled by AMZ. I don't know what that
means. Here we go. Here's one. A Slap in the Face by WB. By Ryan.
Oh. Ryan Gosling?
Sure, yeah.
Gosling.
Just below Mr. Biggs. I need to start off by saying that JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is one of the all-time... It's one of my all-time anime manga series. What even does that mean?
Wait, which one am I looking for?
It's called A Slap in the Face by WB. By the way, guys, if you just go on Amazon.com and put in JoJo's Adventure DVD, you'll find these as well. There's probably even more of them.
I love reading Amazon reviews sometimes. Before you go on, I remember reading a Space Jam review. And someone went on a huge monologue and then like a thesis.
You know what the best one is? The best thing. If you look for like cake decorating spray.
Yeah.
If you look for like the silver cake decorating spray, look at all the comments. It's all people who brought it just after they saw Mad Max. And it's just like all shiny and chrome in Valhalla, and it's all these like movie quotes, and it's like it's hilarious.
Oh my god! Does someone say "Witness me"?
Yeah.
That's great. Shaun, you were saying that for like a month. Witness me.
I'm going to keep saying it, man, because Mad Max comes out next week.
On Blu-ray? Nice.
Yeah, yeah.
You going to buy it?
Anyway. Hell yeah.
Nice.
Best film.
So read...
Unlike this, apparently. The DVD set is absolutely terrible. I'm not basing this review on the quality of the series, of course, but the quality of the physical product. WB decided to slap together a DVD to profit on the growing JoJo fandom. This DVD set is nearly bootleg quality. Hell, I've seen bootlegs of higher quality picture than this. The menus even look something that you would buy in a random stall in Chinatown. Wow, this guy's going in. I don't know why they didn't just invest in putting some quality in the Blu-ray set. Even if they charged double the price for it, I would have thrown down my money in the blink of an eye. Yeah, fair enough. It's just a shame that I feel like I wasted my money on something that could have easily seen for free on a malware-filled streaming site. Same quality and all. If you want to support the Western release of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, go ahead and buy this set. If you want to support the series, get a high-quality product, go and purchase the hardback manga release of Phantom Blood and Tutu Battle Tendency. Wait, is this an advert? Is this guy throwing an advert at the bottom?
Wow.
All three volumes are the same price, and you feel like you've helped yourself out as well as the series.
He's not wrong, but at the same time, he's such a shill.
Oh my god, he just made us sell out. Even more than we already do. People are like, what's actually the quality? 720, 480? You're probably looking at 480 because it's a DVD.
Yeah.
Come on, Like, 720 is HD. HD is a Blu-ray. Like, come on, guy. You're buying an SD release.
This
like...
guy, the next one's... He says the song name and it arrives in America. Honestly, one of the very best anime of recent years that accurately depicts one of the most influential shonen manga of all time. The three-disc set contains Part 1 Phantom Blood and Part 2 Battle Tensei. The picture quality is very good and the sound is clear on both English and Japanese audio tracks. However, one quirk is that the subtitles for the Japanese track need to be open using your remote rather than the menu. Also Ooh. Included is Spanish subtitle track. The acting quality of the English dub voice actors is also surprisingly good, though Patrick Seitz is not quite on par with Koisu. Well, no, he's not going to be.
Oh, no, no one's going
to
be.
Nah, Koisu's very hard to match. The voice actors did their best, though.
That's the voice actor for Dio, by the way, if you didn't know.
This is a series that is a good introduction to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure stories and will be enjoyed by both long time and new anime fans. Wow, that guy's just... I love reading... You read that review, and then this review is just like, it's the best thing ever.
This review's more like a brochure. Like, we just... Everyone's, like, hinting on the subtitles being disappointing.
No one's really going into... more depth with that, by the way. They're just like, they stink.
Yeah.
Wait, what's this review? JoJo fans will love it. My kid loved it, but he'd love dog poo if it was JoJo's dog. I'm getting tired of it being on our TV. Oh my god. This
wow.
Is great. I love
Out
this.
Of nowhere.
This review is amazing. You could, you know what? Amazon reviews, someone should make a Facebook page. It's all just Amazon reviews.
You know what? You know what I'm noticing, actually?
What?
Some of these reviews were done in May. Like, not these ones, but some, if you go back to the other page, like some of the later ones, like page 3. Mm. Some of these are done in May. Stuff wasn't even out then.
Wait, two of them are the same dude.
Like, how would you even know?
Wait, this one in May, and this guy gave it 5 stars. He even said it didn't come out yet.
I just love it.
Wait, no, I gotta read this one. JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is a long-running manga series from Hirohiko Araki in Japan. Did Bryant write this? Sonic Kick 120, I can believe it is him. In Japan, that really didn't get much recognition here in America. You ever heard of Yakuza series from Sega? In regards to distribution in America,
no.
Both treated the same.
No, it's him. That's definitely him.
This is basically just like...
This is basically just like,
hey, let's copy and paste from the wiki. He even mentions the story.
I know. Brian.
He brought up the re-meme. Oh, God.
Brian,
this guy is
Brian,
going...
you get off Amazon, man.
This
get
guy
off.
Even ended it. Now you're going to say I'm going to order this DVD. Toyu. Oh, God.
We're gonna have some words, man. We're gonna have some words, young man.
I love this guy. Warner is awful. He only 3 DVDs. That's absurd. That's too many episodes crammed in the DVD.
Wait, Warner is awful. Like it's just one guy who's doing all this.
I love the picture he posted.
Fucking Warner.
The Amazon picture. And he didn't even crop it right. Oh my god.
I'm gonna post a picture of your picture.
Like, why were people giving reviews for something that wasn't out yet?
Should we review something that isn't out yet?
The first 2 parts of JoJo on DVD. Amazing dedication to the original manga featuring Jonathan Joestar and Joseph Joestar. Okay, guy.
Oh, God. I'm done. I'm losing brain cells just looking at these.
The guy, Arthur, wrote 2 reviews. He's just like... Warner's awful twice. He actually copy and pasted the same thing.
I love these guys, but oh, my brain's hurting now.
Oh my
stop.
God!
Stop! Just please stop.
Yo, a lot of these are just like hype. Sweet JoJo. Wait, let me read this one. Sweet JoJo. Well, I love season 1 of JoJo. The only 2 things that are keeping me from buying This is no Blu-ray set, being the uncensored high-quality version in Japan. Okay, you're a fucking idiot. And the subtitles for Japan audio would be mistranslated due to copyright issues with some characters' names and stuff. Also, I saw a preview of the English sub. Two words. Avoid it.
Ooh.
Ooh. But I like that. The uncensored version, which is what we fucking got.
Yeah, they wouldn't give us the TV version, man. Come on. Like, that would be really mean. Like, yeah, fuck the English.
We should do this more often where we read more of these.
We should.
What about... we should have a whole part where we read Amazon reviews for the part 3 manga.
Oh, God.
I hope someone's just like, here's the entire plot. I'm going to write it down.
You know what my favorite thing is? Have you ever seen, like, an Amazon picture of the JoJo figures? And it's like... Yeah, it'd be like Silver Chariot, and it's like a picture of Dio.
Oh yeah, that's great. It's a Silver, like, Chariot, but it's a picture of the world.
Yeah, and it's like, well, what? No, I saw one where it was just a picture of a character, like a screenshot from the anime. Like, wow. But yeah, we should totally do this. But the thing is, like, as I said before, it's nothing but respect, man. Like, we're not putting you guys on blast, but we're totally putting you guys on blast. Especially Arthur. Come on, man.
Arthur, you're so shit, man. What the fuck?
You're the MVP of shit.
Don't worry. You'll be the top shit lord for now.
You'll be the guest someday.
Don't worry, guys. One day we'll have our Blu-ray version of the OVA. Don't worry. Can you imagine?
It's like that really disappointing Christmas present. It's like,
it's
what I wanted, but it's not what I wanted.
What if, oh my god. Yo, so one other thing to mention about the anime is people, I guess we can segue into that, is the last Blu-ray set finally came out.
Oh yeah, that's a good thing.
It did not have the to be continued at the end. There was no teaser to Diamond is Unbreakable, nothing.
Part 4 is dead.
But people have to understand that when Part 3 ended, there was no 2V continued. It was... That's it. Jotaro beat Dio. There was nothing else. Because that is where JoJo's ends. 1-3. That's it.
Araki got his deck chair. He got his sandals. He was ready. He was ready to quit.
So...
He's out of there.
I think between... Because Araki's done this. He did it with Steel Ball Run. But he really likes the series that he created, obviously. But not every creator is always like, yeah, I want to keep going with it. So my guess... I'm sure it might have been said. But like, he really liked it. And he probably continued it from there. You know.
So what he's saying is, we might get it one day. But
there is an event happening. In October, this month or next, we might see a preview there. People Ooh. Are guessing. There's Ooh. No word. This is just a rumor that people are saying, maybe. But imagine at that festival. This is for JoJo, by the way. I believe this whole thing.
Just for that.
I think it's for JoJo. I don't know. It's some kind of event. I forgot exactly what someone said on a Facebook group. But imagine they're like, Araki comes out himself and he's like, okay, guys, so you want an announcement for the anime, right? And people are like, part 4? He's like, well, I got some news. And people are like, you know, they're really hyped. They're looking. He's like, the Phantom Blood movie's coming out on Blu-ray.
Oh, no, he's announcing, I know you guys like part 4, so it's time for Shigeki Gaiden, where we go into my ninth favorite character ever, and we're gonna give him his own Gaiden story.
Yep.
Why is he such a piece of shit? Find out now. Oh yeah, and part 4 is coming soon. Blah blah blah. Oh, is it heaven though? Yeah,
that's the big thing to look forward to.
He's
honestly
working on that, so give the guy some time to...
Araki, for what it's worth, out of most manga creators in Japan, he's a fairly busy guy. I'm sure there's others, but off the top of my head right now, I can't think of any. But like, Araki does a lot. Like,
he does, man. He's got hobbies as well. God, you know.
I don't know how he you know what? People ask when I was doing Stone Ocean every day, like, how do you do this? How do you manage your time? Like, you know, a better question: how does a Rocky manage his time between doing his ongoing monthly series? You know that it's 40 pages long, almost. Except for the last chapter that came out, that was only 20 something pages. But almost every month is 40 something pages, and he's overseeing this game. He's still doing exhibits.
He's got a lot on his plate.
Whenever they happen, he goes out. He travels a lot. The man's really busy. Most of the time, it's kind of funny for someone who's been doing this since 1987, how he's still going at it. It's
strong
ridiculous.
As well.
Yeah, no, it's the brand will never die. It'll be there forever, but it's amazing how much stronger it's gotten.
It's gonna outlive all of us.
Probably.
That's the sad thing.
Yeah, probably. I won't be able to. I hope. I won't be able to see the end. I'll be dead soon.
No, don't end this on a depressing note. Send it on a high note.
The high note is that I'm great.
Oh, man. Now, the real high note is that we're done.
Yeah.
Episode 3 is done.
Yes.
Guys.
Cut, print.
Cut, print, and... Wait, no, there's more. There's
Whoa.
More, guys.
There's more.
No, there isn't more. Guys, I just want to say, as always, thank you for listening. You guys are great. If you're listening to it and you enjoyed it, share it to your friends. You've got to spread the word, man. You've got to get us
tell
big.
Your tell your family.
Tell your family. Get your family around the table. You know, say it's Thanksgiving. We're going to listen to these two idiots talk.
Just be okay, so it's Christmas, right? And you're really excited. And you're yo, it's 5 a.m. It's a crack of dawn. And your mom and dad are why'd you wake us up? You want to do gifts now? No! We got to listen to the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure podcast hosted by Shaun and Jeff.
Yeah, and they're when we're I think you're adopted.
And then they just sigh and say you were a disappointment and that you had to repeat the same grade because you're stupid.
And then they're like, you don't understand me, Mom. Jumps out the window.
You don't understand, Mom. I really want to listen to this podcast.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm always sorry. But I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to let us know about it. And next week, in 2 weeks, because every 2 weeks, we're thinking of getting our first guest on. We're not going to say who it is, but you guys will enjoy it.
You better.
You guys will love it. You guys will be like, wow, my life has been altered in a positive way. or at least in a way that you can't change that make you feel very uncomfortable.
You'll be like, I grew at least 3 inches taller that day.
Yeah, you'll be getting that ruler out, doing all kinds of crazy shit. I'm gonna stop. Guys, this has been Radio JoJo. I've been Shaun.
And I'm Jeff.
And he's late. I'm out of here. Peace.
Okay, see you.
See you guys. Turning me upside down, waiting for possibilities, don't see too many around.
Written in the stars.